Welcome you on the first online lecture series on subject of building planning and design for TY BTech students. The topic is traditional construction material. So I'm Professor P.A. Hangarkekar from STB College of Engineering to Uzapur. So I deliver a lecture on this topic today. In the beginning only, I welcome you to our college admissions. So the aspirant students who wants to take admission in our college. So I would like to share with them that ours is the college which is being run by Sri Tulja Bhavani Temple Trust, Tuljapur, and headed by Mrs. Deepa Mudhol Munde Madam, who is the Honorable Collector of Usmanabad Districts and Chairman of our college. So the college is having a very good social initiative. That's why we are offering very less fees. Even in the fees, we are giving maximum concession to the meritorious students. And if you could see the chart which is there on the slide, you will see that we are offering even 100% fees concession for the few of the meritorious students who are getting 85% of marks for second year. So I welcome to our college again. And let's start with the academics. So in the first part, we are going to deal with the traditional construction techniques which are related to the stones. So the figure, various sketches shows the jacarch roof, which is previously used in old buildings. Even we could see the wooden roofs being used, wooden structures, small structures, and earth ramming, which is being used for construction of walls. So this also figure shows the various element of a stone masonry work. In this sketch, we could also see a mason is constructing a stone masonry work, and mortar is being used as a cement mortar on the left hand side figure. Whereas on the right hand side, we can say photograph, we could see a dry stubble stone masonry which is being used for the gardening purposes as a compound wall. Then in this sketches we could also see the dry rubble masonries which are being used as a dry stones, and which are basically constructed with the help of a mud mortar inside, or even they could use the lime also, but the exterior joints are free. That's why they are known as dry stone masonry constructions. So this is some advanced example of dry stone masonry being built by French architect Gilles Parardin, and he has designed all this, we can say, with the help of a stone components, or entire masonry is being constructed with a stone box. So, and it is being constructed with the help of a lime as a bonding material. Then one of the major use of stone masonry is gabion stone masonry. So the meaning of gabion is a cage, a big cage. So it is basically an Italian origin. The shapes that we could see, the various shapes that we could see available are rectangular, square, cylindrical, and these are basically interlocking mesh of hexagonal, form. So very good property of this is that in the situations where there can be a landslides, in those situations, stopping the landslide is a major issue. So it is also known as slope stabilization. On such sites, this type of stone masonry can be used. So another very important thing of this is that this can very easily protect the structure from the earthquakes, since it is a gravity retaining wall. And also it could dissipate the water in faster way. Then another benefit is that it is also economical, low cost, with low, we can say, low labor costs. This is eco-friendly, this is aesthetical. The next type of a masonry that we could also see here into details is that it is a random rubble. So it could be used in various, we can say, arches and chajjas also. So this is basically the stone, as we know, it is originated from the various types like granite, trap, limestone, sandstone, quartzite, etc. The properties required for construction The stone should be hard. It should have very good sound, durable, free from weathering effects. That it should be there should be free, it should be free from various flaws. That it should have uniform appearance. Its quality and texture should be good. It should be free from the crypts, crystalline silica, and other, we can say, impurities. Its compressive strength should also be very good. And last and not the least, but very important property is that it should not absorb the water more than 5%. If it is a laterite stone, this standards it has been reduced to 12%. So this is a random rubble masonry that is being shown in the figure. Since it is not a coarse rubble, it is not, we can say, any type of bond being used. The stones are randomly placed. So that's why its name suggests that it is a random rubble masonry. So when it is being used in the, we can say, arches or the, we can say, curvings, we have to use the stone slabs, and it should not be less than 60 centimeter in length. It should have minimum bearing on the sloping chajja with, we can say, 20 centimeters. Then it should have a hole to, we can say, insert mild steel bars. The hole diameter should be 12 mm, and at the same time it should contact, or it should take all the, we can say, courses in a better way. The exterior finishing, that we what we call it as a paint pointing, it should be done in 1:2 cement mortar. It will give us, we can say, it will a very good appearance. At the same time, it will protect the stone masonry from the weathering effects. But these are the, this figure shows the various fine molded stone masonry surfaces. We could also see that what are its effect. If it is a hammer dressed, rock faced, even we can say rough tooled, fine tooled, as per the requirement, we could dress the stone. So this dressing of the stone is also known as molding of the stones, and it should be molded in that required size. These are the certain advanced application of a stone masonry, what we can say as a sunk molded stone masonry. So here the stones required are regular in shape, they should be chiseled dressed, no waviness, and it should be horizontal and vertical joint should be perfect. You could see a very nice constructed dome with a stone masonry. So you will see the all the dimensions are perfectly geometrical. Vertical and horizontal joints are in a better way they are being placed. The face is also very good gauged, good chamfered. Then this is what we can say as a very good type of a stone masonry work. Then it should be dressed in a correct way. Then its shapes are, we can say, circular way, or it is a dome shaped, and its wedges should be very good. The next an advanced application of stone masonry is a stone masonry jalis. So this is basically a mesh, and it should be very finely dressed, so that its the thickness of the jali should it should be specified to 185 centimeters. So it is shown in the drawing, in the photograph, and you will see that it is very finely dressed. Okay, the exposed faces are very good, and it looks very good appearance. So basically it protects from the weathering effects also. It will allow the required amount of sunlight inside the ear, inside the interior form. And this is very good type of a, we can say, olden type of a artwork. In a, we can say, very important and prestigious type of a buildings, like palaces, then various makbaras, masjids. These are the few structures where the stone jali is being provided. So this is one more example of stone art in the jali. You could see how it is perfectly cut in a square form. So this is basically an Indian term. Jali is an Indian term, but it is a lattice screen basically. And in most part of the, we can say, Gujarat and Maharashtra, we could observe such type of a artwork. So this Rajasthan area is, we can say, origin of such a fine stone artwork. So it is a very, it's very, we can say, environmental impacts are also very good. Since, as we know, the temperatures are quite high in Rajasthan, so it will allow the lesser amount of heat. It will protect the building from the sandstorms. It will also allow the movement of flow of air inside the building, which prevents a very good indoor temperature. So this is another form that this work that we are going to do on the stone, this is known as a typical fixing arrangements. In other way, it can also said to be a stone veneering arrangement. So these are the certain, we can say, tools which are required. These are some fastures fixers and fasteners which are being used, basically made up of wooden, we can say, part, which are being used in the stone masonry. The various works that are to be done on this is stone lining, dressing, mortar, laying, and the cramps. So these are the standard sizes of cramps. For 230 mm of wall, it is 25 mm by 6 mm by 30 mm is sufficient. And if the wall in thickness increases, then we have to increase the sizes or dimensions of the cramps. The very good advanced examples that we observe in Rajasthan of this very good artwork of stone is being said to be havelis. Havelis are basically the houses, or the, we can say, palaces built in the Rajasthans. So they are very famous. Some of them known to be Patwa ki Haveli, then Nathmal ji ki Haveli, Shekhawati Havelis, Mandwa Havelis, Salim Sheikh ki Haveli, and many more. So this is all, these all photographs are being copyrighted. And see, these Havelis is a famous part, a famous type of a stone masonry work or stone masonry buildings in Rajasthans. So you will see the photographs of this, how beautiful interiors are being carved. You will see a very good, you can say, artwork, and this is being done in the stone part. You will see a very nice look of these Havelis. So it is being, we can say, coupled with the gardening work. You will see it's very good design and fine artwork. These are the some of the photographs. So in Rajasthani construction of a stone masonry work, the jharokas and chhatris, these are the, we can say, stepwells, johats and jalis, these are the certain elements which are going to be repeated again and again, and they provide a typical Rajasthani work. You will observe all these what I mentioned in the photograph. You will observe the jharokas also. Jharokas are the small windows. So there can be two benefit of this small windows, that if it is a small, it will protect from the exterior weathering effects. At the same time, it can be very well used in the olden palaces, from where the, we can say, ladies from the palaces, they could see the outward scene very easily. At the same time, the outsiders could not see what is there inside, what is happening inside. So this is what we can say, a one-way view is being, we can say, given or offered by the small type of windows. So these are all, we can say, beauty of stone construction. Now let's go to the second part of this topic, that is brick construction. So you will see that there are various types of brick bonds or brickwork, basically being used in the olden times also. So basic materials they were using is a mud, soil, lime and mortar. So these are the, we can say, the bonding material being used in the various types of brick bonds. So as we know that soaking of bricks is a first step, selecting a very good type of a brick. After that, it should be soaked, and it should see that how much water it is going to be absorbed depending upon the strength. If we are using the we can say brickwork in arches, then we have to remember that we have to do certain, we can say, supporting work, supporting structure to construct the arches. So it is being shown in the figure, and it is also given in the notes also, that skew backs shall be dressed the bricks of the spandrel wall at their junctions with extra dose, and arch shall be cut to fit the curvature of the earth. So this archwork, so while constructing the archwork, we should not start from the top, we should start the archwork constructing from the two ends. Okay, and it should be supported in between with formwork, and start constructing by either, we can say, sides, and come up at the center, and it should be keyed. You will also see that there are certain keys, they are being provided as a joints from the two sides of construction, construction from the either side, and then this brickwork has to be, we can say, joints should be flushed. Then this is a, we can say, circular arches. There can be flat arches also, So this selection of this arch depends upon the how much span, for how much span we are going to provide the brickwork. So this is a traditional art of construction of brickwork. Some of the, we can say, advanced type of we can say joints, which is being very famous nowadays, which is environmentally sustainable also, and which is going to protect the indoor air conditions, is rat trap wall. So this is a brickwork which is going to provide a gap between the two layers of a brickwork. The only difference between a common brick bond and rat trap bond is that we are going to lay the brick in a vertical way. So generally we lay the brick on the horizontal side. Here in this case, we are going to lay the bricks in a, as shown, it should be laid in a vertical way, and see the compressive strength of vertical brick. So when it is going to placed on the edges, then it is going to be much increase. Its compressive strength is also much increased. At the same time, we are going to keep certain cavity in between, so which could prevent the, we can say, entry of heat, at the same time sound, from interior and exterior parts. Its strength work is also good, and it should also save the 20-25% materials also. Its appearance is also nice. If it is unplastered, then concrete block masonry is again, what we can say, advanced application of brick masonry nowadays, which is going to give a speedy construction, and even it is going to save the 10-25% of the cost. Its wall thickness is also reduced to 20 cm to 15 cm also. Rather constructing 23 cm wall, you could reduce its thickness. And the very good thing is that it is going to consume only 1/3 of the energy that is required for the brickwork. So this is also safe. This is also very good material. We should use this material to conserve the soil. Then the third part in this chapter is the traditional constructions using timbers. You will see a very nice look of a timber construction material. So before going to the timber construction material, we have to understand what are the types of timbers. In that, first is a teak, rosewood, sal, sandalwood, sisam, oak, pine, jack, irul, mahua, deodar, mahogany, mango, neem and palm. These are the various types of trees which give us a very good type of a timber which is being used in the construction. The photographs shows the salwood logs, the sandalwood, the teak wood, the sisam wood logs and the oak wood. The next step is the tools. So photograph shows the various tools required for the, we can say, wooden construction. And a traditional house is always, we can say, a very energy efficient house. And you will see that a house is being constructed with the help of a timber. At the same time, it is being covered with a soil, so it is going to maintain its, we can say, thermal component or its temperature inside without any, we can say, air conditioning nor any we can say energy. Its indoor temperatures are always comfortable. So this is a traditional technique of constructing the woodworks. Then some of the old constructions that we observe in our country, which are said to be the various types of wada constructions. We will see that these wada constructions are being covered with a very good type of timber roofs. These timber roofs are being supported with the beams. At the same time, they are being covered with a certain layers of a soil. In a majority cases, the white soil is being used, which has a very good thermal absorption capacity. So the figure first shows that type of, you can say, roof work in a wada work, and in the second figure it will also show that the supporting structure for this roof, while in case of its restoration. The third figure shows the Madras terrace roof. So you will see that rather using the soil, we could also use the bricks. So as we know that bricks is having spongy nature, so it can also very easily absorb the high temperature, and at the same time it will not transfer any type of a heat to the lower atmosphere. The finished terrace roof is shown in figure 4. The advanced work in wood is wood carving. Wood carving is basically, as just we had seen in the Rajasthan, in the Sekhawati house. At the same time, while crafting the stone, they are going to craft the wood also. And you will see a very, we can say, nice and delicate wooden, we can say, carvings that you will see in the photographs. So at that time, these are basically the Hindu, we can say, cultures. These Kondwas are Kondwas Hindus, we can say, living in the Rajasthan. So they have worked for this, we can say, doors, very nicely carved doors. There are certain, we can say, beliefs at that time that most of the, we can say, doors are they are going to be placed in the direction of east. They protect their houses from the direction of, we can say, south, which is said to be the Yama direction. So these are certain beliefs at that time related to the ambient atmosphere, and this was the wooden culture in at that time. This another photograph shows, this is Ainamane, or this is said to be a central courtyard. So in the Wada system, the Wada system is being protected from the exterior walls. So all the exterior walls, we don't have any type of a windows which are facing to the in the exterior wall to the ambient atmosphere. So the reason may be to protect the houses from the, we can say, rival clans, even wild animals, protect from the, we can say, environmental effects, from the thefts. So this protection was given. So all the, we can say, all the natural elements like light, air circulation are being provided by this Anamana courtyard, which is being placed at the central, we can say, part in the, we can say, Wada system. So this is basically located in the, we can say, southern, in the south part India of we can say south part South India, and basically the Malabar and the North Kannada from the Karnataka states, a very good craftsmen are being available in there. Then this traditional constructions using bamboo, let's start with that. So these are the various, we can say, aspects of bamboo construction, that it is quite cheap, fast growing material. It is a very good mechanical properties, but if we are going to construct the houses only by bamboo construction, it is little bit difficult. So these are the various types of connections which is going to increase the length of bamboos. So this is the first type, which is a friction type rope. Another is a more tight connections. They are being used with the help of a cocoas, or cocoa is a palm fiber used for tying up the various bamboos. And this fibers, the cocoa fibers, are, we can say, taken from the wood, and they are being used for tightening works. So this is another type of a construction connection, which is said to be the plug-in bolt connection. So you will see this is also we can say a good type of a connection which going to transfer the load from vertical to horizontal members. And you will see that bamboo is going to be cut at the central location, and another small beam is being inserted for the purpose. That's why this is said to be the plug-in or bolt connection. Then in case of, you will see a number of connections, or we can say a central joint, which is going to give birth of number of connections of bamboos. So this is known to be the pan-spatially framework. So this is going to be used in various type of space frames in the bamboos, and they can transfer 50% of their tractive force to the compressive forces in the front plate necessary. So the diameters are smaller than 80 mm. They are very good used in the wooden stresses. Then let's go to the mud construction. This is basically a very conventional and old art, and we will observe this very good we can say paintings on the house. This is known as a Varali paintings. This is basically from Vidarbha in Maharashtra, and you will see the total house is constructed with the help of a soil, and it is being covered with a natural material. So earth construction is also one more, we can say, element which is going to be constructed with the help of a thatch roof, and it is going to be very, we can say, environmental effects, and the construction is quite, we can say, simple with the help of a soil stabilized blocks. So common stabilizers being used are cement and lime, and with these stabilized blocks the brickwork is being constructed, and it is being protected with the help of a thatch roof. These are environmentally stable connections. So some of the connections, we know that the Bhuj area or the Kutch area in Gujarat, which is a highly earthquake prone area, this comes under the fifth zone, that is high risk areas. And in such areas people have started constructing a different type of a house. It is known as a bunga. So bunga meaning a tortoise. So it's just like in tortoise, we could see it from hard from the exterior part and soft from inside. In the similar way, a house which is circular in plan is being constructed. At the same time, its top part is being given with a circular thatch roof, and so there are many purposes behind constructing such type of houses. First thing is that this area observe a very high temperature variations up to 48 degrees centigrade in the summer. At the same time, in even the temperature goes less than 0 degree in the winters. So the extreme temperature variations are there. Again there are certain, we can say, sandstorms and cyclonic winds that are present in Rajasthan. So this circular shape is also going to protect from such sandstorms. As we learned that circle is the least amount of shape, okay, just like a raindrop, okay, it is the least amount of a shape which is more stable, right? So these type of houses are more stable and very famous in, we can say, parts of Rajasthan and Gujarat. Another advanced example of mud construction or earth construction can be Aure Valley Visitor Center. So this Aure Valley Visitor Centers, they have used one technique called as Compressive Stabilized Earth Blocks or CSEB. So this technique is being used in which we can say earth is rammed, then wattle and daub, cove, this adobe, which is a circular part, earth bag poured in the earth. So, and you will see a very good type of, we can say, bricks which are made up from the earth are being used here, and they are giving a circular shape, and these shapes are quite interesting. Then another example is there from the Himachal Pradesh. So this is basically a Spiti Valley. So this Spiti Valley has a very good tradition of rammed earths. You will see the machines are ramming the earth. So it is, they are casting the floor, and in the floor they are using this earth layer. So it is loosely spaced, especially it is loosely spaced and hammered with a wooden hammer. The purpose behind this is that they want to keep certain air gaps in between, which is going to work against the environmental, we can say, effects like excessive cold and high temperatures. So this is a tradition of, we can say, Spiti Valley in the Himachal Pradesh, and a very good example of rammed earth which is being used in the Spiti Valley. This is one more example of earth-based, we can say, building technologies. So it is a Kaza Community Center in the Spiti Valley from Himachal Pradesh, and we'll see the building is at the level of completion, and all the elements, most of all the elements in the building are being used with a rammed earth. So special, we can say, structural shapes have been finalized. You will see the various types of jalis being used in the windows. So then all the work is being used in the earth based materials, that is from this we can say brickwork, at the same time the floor slabs and all. So these are the few references from where I have collected the information. and I've studied all this. These are very good references. I'm sharing all these references with you, my dear students. And if you have any, we can say, problems and any doubts, please post me the SMS on the WhatsApp group, and convey me the you like this lecture or not. Also, thanks for patient listening.